have with us now John Mace Grunsfeld, who has not climbed Everest or K2, but he's been higher than any climber in America, I'm sure, and because he's an astronaut. John, thanks a lot for taking the time out of the meeting and coming up to talk to us for our video series for the AAC libraries and Golden and Jackson Hole, the Climbers Ranch.
My pleasure to be here. I think the distinction probably goes to a fellow named Jeff Hoffman, who's a colleague of mine and went to repair the Hubble Space Telescope mission and is also a climber. He went up a little bit higher than I did, but relatively insignificant. A lot of mountaineers are also astronauts.
Higher in space than you?
Higher in space than you.
Okay. Well, let's talk about your space activities first. Tell us about what your most recent flight was and how it went.
Well, I had the great fortune to be assigned to a mission to the space station Mir. And this was last January 1997. And we took off with Jerry Leninger, a medical doctor aboard, launched into orbit, spent a few days catching up with the Mir, and we docked with the Mir space station and dropped Jerry Leninger off and picked up John Blaha. John Blaha, an American astronaut, had been up there for 4 months, and he was very glad to see us. And we gave the Mir space station about 6,000 pounds of supplies, water, food, scientific experiments, explored the Mir. That was a lot of fun. And then took John Blaha back home.
And you're up how long?
We were up for 10 days.
10 days. John, in, you know, in climbing, we go up inch by inch. It must be quite a thrill to sit in that shuttle and have all of that power behind you and lift off from Canaveral and go soaring up. How do you describe that?
It's pretty interesting. Going on a space shuttle mission and going on a big mountain are very similar. You spend upwards of a year preparing, and lots of people are involved. You can't do it alone. And all of that comes together for a space shuttle mission when you climb into the vehicle on launch day. And we climb into the space shuttle about 2 hours before launch, and they close the door, and we're lying in our seats, actually on our backs, in our spacesuits. The spacesuits weigh about 85 pounds with the parachutes. And after they close the door, everybody else who is in the vicinity of the space shuttle and on the launch pad tries to get as far away as possible. And that's because we're sitting on 4.5 million pounds of explosives, rocket fuel. The countdown occurs, and all this time, you know, we're thinking about our training, thinking about our job, doing, flipping some switches, monitoring systems, and it's not until you get inside of about the last 10 seconds that you really think about what's going to happen. And this last flight was my second flight, so I had a little bit of an idea of what it's like, having been through it once. But the space shuttle acceleration is so great, and the force is so tremendous that you really can't prepare for it even a second time. I mean, you remember what it's like, but when the solid rocket motors light, it is such a kick in the pants and such raw acceleration that, you know, it's hard to describe. At the very least, you know you're going somewhere very quickly. It's not really clear where you're going except up. We accelerate from a standing start such that by the time we clear the launch tower, which is at about 200 feet, we're doing over 100 miles an hour. And it's only seconds till we're faster than the speed of sound and out into space.
At this point, you can't move.
You pretty much can't move. I mean, you can move your arms.
Your mind's working, but you can't do
right,
that.
And you can look around, but that's about it. You're strapped in pretty tight.
And how long are you up before you can do, like, the white knuckle flyers, commercial flyers, mm-hmm. the business people, whatever, the tourists? You know, when you get up and it's sort of leveled off, and maybe you can see this, you get through the clouds and
well, actually, it's 8.5 minutes.
8.5 minutes?
And the reason it's 8.5 minutes is the launch is the most violent event. There's no question, you know, a space shuttle lifting off of planet Earth is not a gentle thing. It is a violent event. And anybody who's seen one or heard one, even watching it on television, you can see the amount of energy involved. Getting to space is very hard. That's the bottom line. And so there's a lot of energy involved. And once you launch, you're getting about one extra G of acceleration. You know, sitting here on planet Earth right now, we have one G of acceleration. That's what's pulling us towards the planet. When we launch, we add another one. And that's true all the way up for the first 2 minutes until the solid rocket motors separate from the space shuttle, at which point we lose the mass of those solid rocket motors. We're already well out of the atmosphere, and the main engines, which have been running this whole time, start throttling up, and we start accelerating. And after about 6 minutes, we weigh about 700 pounds. You know, that acceleration is pushing us into our seat, and it feels like you weigh 700 pounds. It's often described as a big gorilla jumping up and down on your chest. At 8.5 minutes, that's when the engines turn off, and we go from feeling like we weigh 700 pounds instantaneously to weightlessness. You know, and that's when you level off. That's when you suddenly feel the joy of, one, having survived launch, and two, being in space. And for the rest of the journey...
At that point, you're in orbit?
At that point, you're essentially in orbit. You're in space. We have to do one more rocket burn half an orbit later to stay in space, but that's a technicality. That's orbital mechanics. The glory of getting there is all contained really in that instant when you go from, you know, being pushed back into your seat with three Gs, 700 pounds, to weightlessness. And you feel a giddiness at that point because it's a feeling that we're not used to. And it's unusual and it's wonderful. And the neat thing about being in space is it lasts the whole space mission.
The good feeling and the weightlessness.
Yeah. And you start to learn how to adapt very quickly. And on my second mission, it was like I'd come home. You know, I just felt like I was in the right place. And it's very much the same feeling I get when I go out to the mountains. I live in Houston now. It's a city. And you know, you get caught up in all of the day-to-day issues and jobs and working engineering solutions. And when I go out into the mountains, I feel like I'm home again. Same thing is true in space.
John, when you obviously you have time, a lot of time to look around when you're up there. I know you have your assignments and you're very busy, but either with your cameras, as a climber, I assume you are eager to take a look at some of these big peaks and see what they look like from. Do you get good views of Everest?
Depends on your mission. Because of the reality of orbital mechanics, some of the great mountain ranges will be in darkness the entire flight.
Mm-hmm.
This last flight, I was very fortunate. We had many good views of the Karakoram and the Himalayas. And I had a little fold-out map of the Himalayas where I had drawn pictures of certain guideposts so that, you know, once I could find Dalagiri and Annapurna, I could then go through and find, you know, many of the other high peaks. One of my goals was to see Nanga Parbat and K2. On this last flight, and I wasn't successful.
Oh.
And so I have more to do in looking at the Earth from space. And we do carry cameras. We have Hasselblad cameras, and they make wonderful pictures. They take wonderful pictures.
And you're at this point, you're how many miles high?
230 nautical miles.
200?
Yeah, almost 300 miles above the Earth. And so it's, you know, in real terms, it's not that high. On the other hand, we're traveling 17,500 miles an hour. And so over the surface of the Earth, we travel 5 miles every second, 92 minutes around the Earth. And so you get to see quite a lot. And if you do see a mountain you want to take a picture of, you have to be quick.
Yeah.